So hello and welcome once again to our channel on TechWorks. Today I have brought a very interesting topic for you, that is to study the electricity bill. Most of the times we are aware about the electricity bill which is being delivered to our residential premises, but we don't know as to what are certain terms, certain units in that electricity bill. So today I'll try and make an attempt to introduce you to most of the terms which are related to our electricity bill. Before we start the video, I request you all to please hit the subscribe button at the bottom and like the video as well. So, electricity bill. We all know as to an electricity bill is being delivered to our residential premises, to our house, at the end of the every month. But why do we have to pay this electricity charges? Why is electricity bill delivered at your home? So the answer to that is there are a lot of people who are involved in delivering electricity with uninterrupted supply to our residential premises, to the various industries, commercial complex, and so on. There are various skilled laborers and unskilled persons also who are responsible for various generation, various transmission and distribution related work. Hence, their salaries are to be paid. Secondly, these transmission companies, these generation companies, they try and purchase various equipments. They purchase these equipments at some time on the basis of loans. These loans are to be paid back. The interest are to be paid back. Hence, these electricity companies try and recover these charges from its consumers. So, who are the consumers? We who consume this electricity are the consumers. That is why we have to pay our electricity bill. That is why we have to pay our electricity charges. Now, the question is, how do these companies charge you? On what basis do they charge you for the electricity consumed? That is what we'll be studying in this particular video. I have downloaded this video from the official website of Mahavitran or MSEB, you can say Maharashtra State Electricity Distribution Company. I'll also show you as to how you can download this electricity bill from the official website. At times, there's no need for you to wait for the hard copy of the bill which is to be delivered at your home. You can directly view the electricity bill on the official website of MSEB. I'll try and show it to you when we proceed with the video. This bill is being given in the regional language, that is Marathi here. And there are certain terms here which are mentioned in the video. We'll try and introduce ourselves to all those terms. To begin with, I'd like to mention that this is the electricity bill for the month of July 2020. There's something called as GSTIN of MSEDL. We all know as to what is GST. GST is nothing but its Goods and Service Tax Identification Number. This is the GST number of MSEDCL. Here on the right hand side, you can see there's something called as HSN code. HSN code is nothing but it's an harmonized system code. It is given for the classification of goods. Further, you can see here there's something called as bill number. Bill number is nothing but it's a unique 15 digit number for every consumer, right? It is a unique bill number which is being given for every bill, for every other consumer. There's something called as GGN. GGN is nothing but it is a Go Green initiative which is being started by MSEB and today by most of the distribution companies as well. If you can scroll down, if I can scroll down here, you can observe here that this particular distribution company also mentions that if you go for the Go Green initiative, that is if you opt that a hard copy of electricity bill is not delivered at your place, then there can be savings of almost 10 rupees behind your electricity bill. So this is a wonderful initiative which this distribution company has started. Further, you can observe that there's something called as ग्राहक क्रमांक और इट इज ऑल्सो टर्म्ड एज कंज्यूमर नंबर। इट्स अ 12 डिजिट यूनिक नंबर गिवन टू ईच ऑफ द कंज्यूमर्स। दिस इज फॉर आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द कंज्यूमर एंड ऑल्सो इट गिव्स अ ज्योग्राफिकल आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द premises in which the customer is located. So your consumer number is always very important, and the consumer number is going to be the same all throughout. So consumer number is a 12-digit unique number given to each of the consumers. Then the second thing is about your address. Now the address is one such thing which is very important. Apart from paying charges and viewing the electricity bill is also a very important document when it comes as a proof of residence also. That is why one has to always remember that his electricity bill, the address mentioned on the electricity bill is almost perfect. If there is any discrepancy, if there is any correction which is to be wanted in your electricity bill, one can definitely approach the distribution company, or there are certain measures which one can do by doing the address correction online. In the next video which I will be doing, I'll try and make an attempt to introduce ourselves as to how address correction can be done online. Next, I'll proceed ahead to the next term, that is it's the information related to our mobile phone and email ID. One can really update his email ID and mobile number also on this portal. So in case of there is any discrepancy in power distribution, there's power cutoff, one can directly text from his registered phone number as well. So that is a wonderful initiative as well. Further, we'll go ahead to the billing unit. Now, this is something called as billing unit. The billing unit is in 4 digits. It's here in this case, it is 4610. That is the division in which the city you are located. Your billing unit is 4-digit number, and it is different for each of the zones in the city, right? So this is the billing unit. Then there's something called as Dar Sanket. So you can observe that this is a low tension or residential single phase meter which I am making use of. This is nothing but it is a type of supply which is being given to the consumer. Then there's something called as pole kramank. What is pole kramank? It is the pole kramank here is 00. That means it's an indication that the supply, the electricity, is being fed by underground cables. Secondly, pole kramank is very important when there's a power cut, when there is a problem on near in your premises. We normally call the distribution company, we normally call the technician. He normally asks us what is the pole number. So these poles are the ones which fed us electricity. So they may be given in number 1, 2, and so on. So pole number is very important. It is the consumer who is being supplied from this pole number nearer to the transformer. During complaint, this pole number is very important. Next, we have something called as PC. We are very familiar with, online payment these days. We try and pay our electricity bills on various online apps as well. So they ask you as to what is your PC. The PC is nothing but this is your processing cycle. PC is nothing but it's your processing cycle, and it's being elaborated from 0 to 8, right? In this case, in my case, the PC is 4. The significance of this PC is that the electricity bill is being generated in cycles, so that all the customers do not come and pay the electricity bill at the same time. That is why these group of consumers are being divided into this processing cycle in which the electricity bill is generated. So that can be from 0 to 8. In my case, it is 4. Normally, when we pay our electricity bill online also, they normally ask you as to what is the PC. So it's your processing cycle, the cycle in which your electricity bill is being generated. And it's very important that this PC is a part of our billing unit. Secondly, this is Chakra Marga Kram. तो चक्र मार्ग क्रम, ये क्या होता है कि लाइक अगर कोई प्रॉब्लम आता है, देयर इज पावर कट, और इवन यू कैन से व्हेन टेक्नीशियन गोज ऑन टू वेरियस रेसिडेंशियल प्रेमाइसिस टू कलेक्ट द रीडिंग्स ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मीटर्स, ही इज गोइंग टू फॉलो दिस पैटर्न, और इज गोइंग टू फॉलो दिस रूट. इट इज द रूट एंड द सब रूट विच द रीडर हैज टू फॉलो वाइल ही इज कलेक्टिंग दोज रीडिंग्स ऑफ द मीटर. देन दर समथिंग कॉल्ड एज डीटीसी. ये डीटीसी क्या होता है? डीटीसी इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ट्रांसफॉर्मर सेंटर नंबर, राइट? दिस इज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ट्रांसफॉर्मर सेंटर नंबर. इट्स बिंग रेड अलॉन्ग विथ योर बिलिंग यूनिट एज वेल. उसके बाद आता है मीटर क्रमांक. मीटर क्रमांक मतलब एक यूनिक 11 डिजिट नंबर होता है, वो हर एक मीटर को दिया जाता है. दैट इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी द सेम ऑल थ्रू आउट. फर्दर वी हैव अ रीडिंग ग्रुप. यहाँ पे एक रीडिंग ग्रुप दिया गया है. रीडिंग ग्रुप अलग अलग कैटेगरीज के लिए होता है, जैसे कि रेसिडेंशियल हो, कमर्शियल या फिर इंडस्ट्रियल कस्टमर्स के लिए. डिपेंड करता है कि आप कौन सा मीटर यूज कर रहे हो. आप इलेक्ट्रोमैकेनिकल मीटर यूज कर रहे हो या इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टाइप मीटर यूज कर रहे हो, उस कैटेगरी में ये रीडिंग ग्रुप दिया जाता है. देन द समथिंग कॉल्ड एज पूर्ववर्ता दिनांक ऑन द राइट साइड. दैट इज दैट डेट ऑन विच दिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मीटर वॉज कमीशन और दे हैव स्टार्टेड इंस्टॉल दिस मीटर. सो दैट इज दैट डेट जिस दिन आपका इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मीटर कमीशन हुआ. सो दैट इज मेंशनड हियर. उसके बाद देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज मंजूर भार. मंजूर भार इज नथिंग बट इट इज योर सैंक्शन लोड. वॉट इज सैंक्शन लोड? द लोड इन KW which the supply company has agreed to deliver the consumer from time to time. So in this case it is 4 kW, or you can also say it is 4 kW. Then there's something called as Suraksha Thev Jama. So as the name suggests, it is the fixed deposit which one has to keep it with the distribution company. So in this case it is almost 2,000 rupees. Then you can also observe here the reading taken, the Chalu reading Dinank, that is the reading was taken here on this particular date, that is 15th of July, and the last reading, that is Magil reading Dinank, was taken on 16th of June 2020. And here on the right hand side you can see there's a QR code, so one can directly scan this QR code from any particular payment app, and he can directly pay his electricity bill. This is a wonderful initiative which this distribution companies have started. And one more advantage of this kind of payment is that they have started giving certain incentives as well. You can see here on point number 2, डिजिटल माध्यमाद्वारे वीज बिल भरावं, 0.25% सवलत मिळवा. सो वन कॅन डेफिनेटली मेक यूज ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ ॲप्स टू यू नो टेक सम इन्सेंटिव्ज आउट ऑफ इट. सो इट्स अ वंडरफुल इनिशिएटिव. सो ऑन द टॉप इयर यू कॅन सी देयक दिनांक एज टू आपको किस तारीख तक, कौन से डेट तक आपको ये इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल भरना है, आपका इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल आया कितना है, ये भी यहाँ पे मेंशन किया गया है. एक डेट दी जाती है, उस डेट के बाद अगर आप ये इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल भरते हो तो आपको एक काइंड ऑफ पेनल्टी लगता है, लेट चार्जेस आते हैं. सो वो लेट चार्जेस यहाँ पे मेंशन किया गया है, दैट इज 310 रुपीज. उसके बाद अगर आप यहाँ पे देखोगे तो देयर इज द स्टेटस ऑफ द सिस्टम. नॉर्मल दिखा रहा है कि लाइक अगर कोई गलती तो नहीं हुई है, कोई थेफ्ट तो नहीं हुआ है, इसलिए द स्टेटस ऑफ द सिस्टम इज शोइंग एज नॉर्मल. उसके बाद एक बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग बार ग्राफ यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो कि लाइक आपने पिछले महीनों में कितना इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कंज्यूम किया. तो जैसे कि जून 2020 में इट हैज राइज टू ऑलमोस्ट 275 यूनिट्स, राइट? बिकॉज द यूनिट्स वो अक्यूमुलेटेड इन जून 2020, एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर मंथ आई हैव मेड यूज ऑफ 79 यूनिट्स. द एनर्जी कंज्यूम्ड इज 79 यूनिट्स. ओके, सो हम लोग थोड़ा आगे बढ़ते हैं. वील सी द नेक्स्ट ऑफ नेक्स्ट पैरामीटर्स. हियर यू कैन ऑब्जर्व द कस्टमर नंबर, द बिलिंग यूनिट, द पीसी नंबर, द रीडिंग ग्रुप एंड ऑल. वंस अगेन दे आर मेंशनड हियर ऑन द स्क्रीन. फर्दर हाउ इज दिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल बिंग distributed, or you can say, how is this electricity bill categorized? It is categorized in certain fixed and certain variable charges. It also depends upon how much electricity you are consuming. Right now, in this case, if you can observe here, अगर मैं अगर ऊपर जाता हूं तो यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हो कि मैंने 79 यूनिट्स कंज्यूम किए हैं. मैंने 79 यूनिट्स कंज्यूम किए हैं, तो वो 79 यूनिट्स का बिल उन्होंने कैसे मुझे लगाया है वो मैं यहाँ पे चेक कर सकता हूँ. दैट इज फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट स्थिर आकार और फिक्स चार्जेस. दिस इज द फिक्स चार्जेस. 110 रुपीज इज द फिक्स चार्जेस विच दे हैव अप्लाइड. देन देयर समथिंग कॉल्ड एज विज आकार, दैट इज द यूनिट्स विच आई हैव कंज्यूम. डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दैट द रेट विच इज बिंग अप्लाइड टू मी इज 273 रुपीज. वहन आकार, या फिर यू कैन ऑल्सो कॉल इट एज व्हीलिंग चार्जेस. डिफरेंट मेंटेनेंस वर्क हैज टू बी यू नो कैरिड आउट फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम रिलेटेड टू द ट्रांसमिशन टावर्स, द पोल्स, द इंसुलेटर्स एंड ऑल. सो दीज आर नथिंग बट दीज आर द व्हीलिंग चार्जेस. एंड यू कैन ऑब्जर्व इट इज एट 1.45 रुपीज पर यूनिट. नाउ यू कैन ऑब्जर्व यर दैट आई हैव मेड यूज ऑफ 79 यूनिट्स. सो इन दैट केस द व्हीलिंग चार्जेस विल बी 79 1.45. So that has to give me 114.55. So you can observe here, it's one and the same. Besides that, the tax which we have to pay is being applied at 16%, and all this accumulates here. All of this is being added here to get the total final charge, electricity charge which I have to pay, that is 577 rupees. And in case there are some extra charges which I paid in the last month which are to be adjusted, or there are certain incentives which are being declared by the distribution company, then they are also adjusted here in minus. And you can observe there, in that case, finally my electricity bill accumulates to 300 rupees. You can also verify this charges or this breakout on the official website of MSEB. The official website is being shown here. This is the official website on which you can directly go and view and click on view or pay bill. If I click here, there's a tab which opens which mentions as to which type of consumer you are. Let's say I am a LT consumer. You have to put your consumer number here. Once you click here, you can put your consumer number here. Then the billing unit, my billing unit is 4610. I can put the billing unit here. It directly identifies as to which area or subdivision it is. So that is very useful. Secondly, you have to enter the captcha, and then you can submit, and you can then the bill is being generated in the PDF format in which you can view and pay the bill further. Secondly, if I want to see this breakout, I want to verify this breakout, I can verify this breakout on the official website here. Like you can click here on energy bill calculator. You can mention the type of supply. In my case, it is LT. Your tariff, the tariff, it's a residential tariff, non-residential, industry, public service. In my case, it's residential, single phase. I'll select this. Then sanction load, manzoor bhar. So here you can observe here on the top, the manzoor bhar is 4 kW, or the sanction load is 4 kW. I'll enter the value here as 4. Connected load, I'll keep it as 3. Phase, I'll select it as single phase. And consumption, you can see here on my electricity bill, the consumption in units is 79. So I'll just put here as 79 and I'll submit here. So you can observe here that the bill, estimated bill, is almost 565. We can also verify here. There is a certain discrepancy difference because of the fixed charges. Here the fixed charges applied 110, and on the website they have mentioned at 100. So that is something which you can really look forward to. In this way, the electricity charges are being broken down, or the breakout of the electricity charges, which includes your fixed charges, the energy charges, the electricity duty or the tax which one has to pay, the wheeling charges, vahan akar, as I mentioned here on the electricity bill. It is here 1.45 per unit, that is 114.55. So yes, here it is. Wheeling charges 114.55, and in case there are any certain fuel adjustment charges or taxes that are accumulated here, and it has to be paid by the consumer. And lastly, I'd like to mention about tariff. Now, this is something called as tariff. There are certain kind of tariffs which are being employed for the consumers. In the first place, what is tariff? Tariff is nothing but the rate at which your electricity is being charged. Now, there are certain tariffs like two-part or three-part tariff, or your maximum demand tariff, or power factor tariff, or even there is time of the day kind of tariff which is being employed these days. So, in our cases, for residential applications, we make use of block rate tariff. This is something called as block rate tariff. From 0 to 100, the rate charge per unit is 3.46. From 101 to 300 units, the rate charge is 7.43 rupees per unit, and so on. So the rate of electricity changes or increases in blocks. That is why this is termed as block rate tariff. So this is something about the electricity bill. I hope this video will help you definitely to understand as to what are certain parameters and important terms of your electricity bill. I hope you liked the video. Please try and subscribe the channel and hit the like button. Subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.